We, as a coalition, has been monitoring events as it unfolds as a result of the fallout of the APC primary elections held on the 3rd and 4th of October 2018 in Zamfara State. These primaries held in the presence of the Zamfara State INEC Resident Electoral Commission, REC, two Assistant Inspector Generals of Police, the State Commissioner of Police, the State Director DSS, across the 147 wards that made up the 16 local government area of the state. Violence erupted in 7 wards out of the 147 wards that make up the state. This led to the cancellation of the elections in the affected 7 local government areas, which held the next day, being 4th of October 2018. But to the dismay and chagrin of everyone, INEC headquarters Abuja recently already issued a statement stating that the elections did not hold in the state, consequent to violence. Now, the questions are, 1, why was INEC headquarters Abuja so much in a hurry to issue a statement even while the primaries were still ongoing? 2, could election primaries that held in 140 wards but could not hold in 7 wards, which later held on the 4th of October 2018, be nullified and assumed to be marred with violence? What is the percentage of 7 to 140? 3, could election primaries witnessed, observed, and signed by the State INEC Resident Electoral Commissioner, two Assistant Inspector Generals of Police, State Commissioners of Police, etc., be assumed to be all violent prone or void? 4, is it possible that INEC is replicating a script written by some clandestine group in Abuja who are not in consonance with the outcome of the primaries? 5, could there be an external force muscling INEC to do its bid against our constitutional rule of neutrality and supposed independence? In line with the provisions of Section 153 of the Electoral Act 2010 as amended, INEC is empowered to make regulations governing any election. In this instance, INEC stipulation that party primaries should end on the 7th of October was adhered to. Then, what on earth could have pushed INEC to this great blunder of our time, especially considering the recent macabre of shame in Ekiti and Osun? Ordinarily, as a civil society coalition, we do not really mind which political party is involved because we are neutral. But with the countdown to 2019 general elections, Nigerians are fast losing confidence in INEC daily. And whether or not INEC still retains any iota of integrity to conduct credible elections in 2019 is a billion-dollar question yearning for answer, but has malignantly remained bizarre in the mind of Nigerians. The international community is also watching with keen interest how an entire state controlled by the ruling party, the APC, is barred from fielding candidates in a primary that was well conducted. Democracy in Nigeria is under threat, and Nigeria in the League of Nations is being constantly mocked. There is a deliberate attempt to truncate due process and toward democratic due diligence and procedure in Nigeria. The reputation of INEC is fast eroded. Fortunately, INEC still has some time to correct this orchestrated shame and national disgrace by doing the needful. INEC, by this medium, is given the maximum of a fortnight to ratify these issues to save Nigeria from the unending laughingstock for which the commission has blocked the nation. May God save Nigeria.